Every other person you meet wears glasses. And if you will ask us why we do that or what are we suffering from, the answer you will get could either be specific, like because you are suffering from myopia or metropia, or sometimes even more specific, like because it looks cool. But the reason why I wear specs is simple, because they help me see things more clearly. But I've never contemplated whether these things are really as I see them. Have you? Good evening, Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and my four-eyed guests. Recently, I sat upon my glasses, unknowingly of course, and surprisingly, it broke. I know, weird, right? But this made me ponder. We repair our glasses when its health is affected. But what about the health of our perspective? How will we know when it is unhealthy? There are many times when we have a single perspective about someone, a single story, on the basis of which we start judging them, the source of which most of the time is unreliable, a third person. People are prejudiced and biased. Most of us are blinded with preconceived notions, with jealousy, suspicion, envy, fear, and pride. And we don't want to change our minds about our daily schedule, our haircut, or our favorite TV shows. I've seen people judging on the basis of religion, college, clothes, cell phones, shoes, and even the number of likes on their Facebook pics. And sadly, sometimes even I am one of them. I remember it was my 10th grade. It was that special day on which a teacher was going to teach us the most awaited chapter of biology. Yes, you all guessed it right. My best friend Rahul and I were sitting on the last bench, and next to her were two girls. One of which was Ananya, Rahul's good friend, and the whole class knew that. During this class, the only class in which each and every student was completely focused, a teacher noticed that Rahul and Ananya were talking and not listening to them. Being irritated, she finally ordered them to stand up and asked them, "Why are you not listening?" To which someone commented, "Ma'am, because they are already very good at this." And the whole class bursted with laughter, including me. But from that day onwards, everything changed. It was common to hear people teasing about Rahul and Ananya in class, corridors, school buses, and even during the morning assemblies. It didn't affect Rahul that much, but Ananya, being a girl, had a reputation to live up to. She had to have a pristine image as per her social norms. Soon, she started receiving implicit comments from people she didn't even know, people who had that one perspective about her. And to see a person from one perspective creates a single story of them in our minds. A single story on the basis of which we judge them. It is not proper at all. The problem with single story is that it robs people of dignity. The consequence is very, very harsh. The single story make the story become the only story, and that is what happened with Ananya. She became what people had heard about her. No one tried to look at her situation from her specs. Ultimately, though she was the topper of her class, she left her school when the session got over with very poor grades. You see, the consequences would have been completely opposite if people had heard her other stories and looked at her from other classes before teasing her. That is why it is extremely important to listen. To listen to that person and get to know all their stories before forming any perspective about them. It is much more difficult than it sounds. It is easier to condemn and criticize than to understand other person's viewpoint. It is more natural to talk about what you want than to talk about what the other person wants. I've always felt that it is impossible to engage with a place or a person without engaging with all their stories. The consequence of single story is this: it robs people of dignity, I repeat. When we realize that there is never a single story, when we reject the single story, we don't just eliminate any possible vicissitude in our relationships, but also open ourselves to change. Because as Benjamin Franklin said, when you're finished changing, you're finished. So from now onwards, take good care of your glasses and keep your perspectives healthy.